hockey and ice hockey?
When I was 6 years old, my mother actually got me started in ice hockey. She figured that all the kids in my family should play as many sports as possible, and ice hockey was one of them, and it was the sport that I kind of just went with the most out of all the sports, so my mother is the answer.
What ice hockey team did you support when you were growing up?
Well, I grew up in the city of Toronto, Ontario, Canada. It's the biggest city in Canada, and they have their NHL team there, the Toronto Maple Leafs. I'm not the biggest fan of them now, but when I was a kid growing up, I was a big Leaf fan, for sure.
What's your favorite team you've played for?
My favorite team? I'd have to say the CCS Dundee Stars, for sure, 100%.
Who was your inspiration?
My inspiration, it's kind of a cliche as a Canadian. Wayne Gretzky was the biggest name when I was a kid growing up. Pretty much has a lot of the records in the NHL. And I bought a lot of his books and stuff as a kid and followed him.
Do you enjoy life in Dundee?
I do. It's very interesting for someone from North America to be playing over here. There's a lot of great things very close, like with St. Andrews close by, with Edinburgh, with the drive away, and you know, it's incredible all the different things that you can see. Like for someone from Canada to be seeing all these castles, just as simple as like the Bratty Ferry Castle. I don't even know if I pronounced that right, but it's very interesting for me just seeing all the sights. And Dundee's a beautiful little city. And I think the players really appreciate it, and we're all happy to be here for sure.
Who has been your toughest fight?
Toughest fight in this league has definitely been Alex Penner from the Nottingham Panthers. That was pretty much the first one I had this year. A lot of people were asking me after that, you know, who's the next one going to be? Is that guy going to be bigger? And I said, well, you know, what you saw that game was the top of the crop. And I'm not saying the other guys aren't tough, but he's probably one of the tougher guys in the league, and that's a huge battle that went on that day, and we'll probably have round 2, 3, 4, who knows how many, but probably Alex Penner, Nottingham Panthers, to cut this question. So,
are you fighting on Sunday on who?
You never really know if it's going to happen for sure, but the Giants have brought in a hired man. His name is Mike Hoffman. He's number 33. He's actually bigger than I am. He's a really big guy. And the chances are that, yeah, we probably will mix it up. It's my old team, so it's going to be an emotional game for me. I'm going to be trying to just play as best as possible. I'm going to try to get my first goal of the season. Our team is trying to get our first win. But I would love to get the crowd into it, take on Big Mike Hoffman as well.
Why in ice hockey is that acceptable to fight?
Well, the difference between ice hockey and a lot of other sports is that, like, ice hockey is a very emotional game. And, you know, when you're allowed to pretty much run someone through the boards and up against the glass and stuff like that, the reason why there is fighting in ice hockey is because it's kind of policing our own game. What we've found is that the leagues that don't allow fighting, there's a lot of cheap shots are given out because of the physicalness of the game. When there's not fighting allowed, you know, players are more I would say willing to, you know, do a high stick with the cross checks and hitting guys from behind and stuff like that. And when you have one guy on each team that over here, I know you guys call them the hard men, it kind of limits the cheap shots. It keeps the game really honest, and it's kind of like policing our own. The game's changed a lot from 10, 15 years ago. There used to be a lot more fighting in the game, and it kind of went down a little bit, and it's kind of gone up and down. And, you know, the way that I look at it is you know, it's not a lot of guys that do it on the teams. It's usually just one or two guys. That's the role that they have. A lot of players have different roles on the team. And there just happens to be one role where, if it comes down to it, that a fight might break out, and that's what it is. It's exciting, and it's definitely, it's for adults. It's definitely not for kids. When I was a kid, I never fought as a kid. I only fought as an adult, and I think that's where people need to learn, like, to draw the line that fighting in hockey is strictly for adults and it's not for kids. When you're a kid, you're trying to be the best player you can, score the most goals, and you don't really need to become a role player until you become a pro. So, fighting fighting is a role that you have on the team, and that becomes later in your career if you turn pro.
What's the difference between Dundee and your hometown in Canada?
The difference, I would say, the city that I grew up in, Toronto, has about, I think it's about 3.5 million people. It's a really big city, the big skyscrapers going around. And, Dundee's a smaller town, but it's a very interesting town, and like how it's kind of built on the, well, what we would call it a mountain, you guys would probably call it a hill or the law, as you say. There's a lot more to see, I think, here. It's the fact that it's right on water, I think that's a big bonus. I've never seen a lighthouse as close to where I live before, and it's just interesting to see different things. And you know, when you're from a big city, you don't get to appreciate, you know, the nature reservoirs that you guys have around here and all that kind of stuff and all the different golfing opportunities and everything like that. Like, I don't have that back home, so it's very interesting to get an opportunity to do different things and to see different things. And you know, when you have so many great towns within an hour and a half drive, that's also a bonus, because in my city it takes about an hour to drive from one side of the city to the other, where if you drive an hour here, you can go through about 10 or 15 cities, so, or towns. So it's very interesting, and I love it, and I'm glad that I'm able to take advantage of being here, for sure.
What is your best ice hockey moment?
My best ice hockey moment? I would probably have to say it was the day that I got drafted to the NHL. I was lucky enough to be a draft pick of the Buffalo Sabres. I was only 18 years old, and you know, just getting drafted to the National Hockey League, it's a lot of kids' dreams growing up in North America, and I know the ice hockey players here, of course, it would be their dream as well. But probably getting drafted was the biggest deal in my career, for sure.
Frank Trelin is interviewing
and
coming in to get an interview.
Thank you very much.